To get a different look and feel for your image, ColorFX has several creative filters, like the Bleach Bypass filter. I have opened PUB. The Bleach Bypass filter simulates a technique from the days of color film, where the bleaching step was skipped. This results in a high contrast, low saturation look. For more creative filters, we will now go to Analog Effects Pro 2, which is the plugin for special effects. This plugin can be very useful for giving a book cover a special look. I have opened the Man on the Train image we made in the Blur Methods lecture. I will create a new from visible layer, so I get a single layer I can open. I go to Filters, Google Nik Collection. I choose Analog Effects Pro 2 and click on OK. At the left, there are some presets. From this point, we can already get some interesting ideas, which we can fully modify at the right. Analog effects, like color effects, works with stackable effects. To get to the individual filters, click on the classic camera icon. Below Tools, we see the filters. Let's have a look at light leaks. I click on it. With light leaks, you can add a light flare to your image. There are many light leaks to choose from. You have soft, crisp and dynamic leaks. You can position a light leak by dragging the blue circle. At the top, you can set the strength of the light leak. As in color effects, I will replace an effect if I click on another effect at the left. To add an effect, in analog effects, you click on the plus icon at the right of an effect. I will add zoom and rotate blur. To remove an effect, click on the minus icon. With zoom and rotate blur, I can bring some movement to text and images. The inner circle is the effect free area, and between the inner and outer circle is the transition area. I can adjust the size of the inner circle and the outer circle. I can also rotate the outer circle. I can drag the circles with the middle blue point. I can also drag the sliders at the right. Because I want to affect only the text and not the background, I will press cancel. In Gimp, I delete the top layer, which came from analog effects, and hide the train image. Now only the text is visible. The text has to be on a black background, so that I can set the result on the screen blending mode. I right-click and choose New from Visible. I go to Filters, Google Nik Collection, and click on OK. I click on the classic camera icon and select Zoom and Rotate Blur. Now I add some motion to the text. I click on Save. In GIMP, I remove my new from visible layer, I hide the original text and show the train layer. I select the analog effects layer and set it on screen. Now let's add some motion to an image. For a thriller book cover, I have opened Barn. I go to Filters, Google Nik Collection and click on OK. I click on the classic camera icon and select the zoom and rotate blur filter. I drag the midpoint on the tree. I will rotate the blur a bit. I click on Save. A related blur effect is motion blur. I have opened Race Car. I would like to bring some motion blur into this image. I go to Filters, Google Nik Collection and click on OK. I click on the classic camera icon and select the motion blur filter. As with zoom and rotate blur, you have the effect free area and the transition area. With the small blue point, you set the angle and the strength of the motion blur. Independent of this main control, you can also add 7 additional blur points to tweak the result. With these additional blur points, you can control the angle and strength locally. To delete an additional blur point, select it and press Delete. I have already saved a finished motion blur effect for this image. The preset, which is called a recipe in color effects, can be found in the custom panel. I named my recipe Race Car. I click on it. Here I have placed the main control at the top and used the 7 additional blur points to tweak the result. To have the driver free of blur, I placed a blur point on the driver and dragged the dot at the end of the arrow fully in. To save a preset, click on the Save Preset button. Like in color effects, to save a preset with control points included, you shift click. You can also update, delete and export the preset. I click on Save. Finally, we will look at bokeh. I have opened Town at Night. I go to Filters, Google Nik Collection and click on OK. I have already made a preset, so I click on the Custom panel. Again, there is an Effect Free area and a Transition area. If you want to, you can change the look of the bokeh. I click on Save. In Gimp, I will remove the bokeh at the top of the tower with a layer mask. I right-click, choose Add Layer Mask and choose White. I select my brush and paint with black. I have now added some depth to my image using the bokeh filter, which is yet another way of blurring. In the next lecture, we will look at making vignettes.